this video is definitely going to get copyrighted. Hey guys, how's it going? James here from Car Audio Etc. It's raining really, really badly. So today I'm making a video that I've actually wanted to make for a while. I did say to you guys a while ago that I would make this video, but it was right before I was about to go away on holiday and things banked up and I didn't have time to do it, so I'm doing it now. Today I am doing a listening test for my new Rockford Fosgate T1 S1-12 subwoofer in my prefabricated but custom strengthened box that I did up. So normally I would get out and show you guys what I've got in my boot, like the subwoofer, the box and the amp and everything like that, but it's pretty disgusting weather and I don't feel like going outside. As you can see, it's just like disgusting outside. But that's okay because, you know, I would be filming this video inside the car regardless of what I'm doing. So instead what I'll do is I'll chuck up some pictures of the amp and the subwoofer in the box and everything like that. So in case you haven't been following along with my build vlog for this car, let me just explain quickly what I've got going on. I've got my Pioneer AVH X8850BT. It's a doubled-in AV unit with CarPlay and Bluetooth and everything you'd expect. High voltage RCA outputs and a high, like 24-bit DAC and FLAC compatibility. So it's a pretty much like top of the line sort of, you know, spec'd out unit. Does really good job. Speakers in the front at the moment are a Focal PS165FX. So that's Focal FLAC series two-way components. The woofers in the doors and the tweeters in the factory tweeter locations. In the back, I've got my Focal PC165F, which are essentially the same speakers but a coaxial version, 6.5-inch coaxial. In the boot, I've got my subwoofer, as I said before, my Rockford Fosgate T1 S1-12. It's a 1-ohm subwoofer, 12-inch, in a prefabricated box, which normally houses a 300-watt sub, a Rockford Fosgate P300-12, but I have modified it to fit and strengthened it for my higher power Rockford Fosgate sub. The amplifier that's driving it all is a Rockford Fosgate T1000 X5AD. So it's a micro amplifier. It's only like this sort of big, but it does 1000 watts RMS total. It drives the sub and all the speakers. So at the moment I've come and parked up on like the top of a hill in a relatively secluded area. Not because I think my music's going to disturb anyone, for a couple of other reasons. A, I'm quite awkward if people come past and see me filming. I don't yet. Yeah. And also because I wanted to go for a wee bit of a drive to give the car some time to warm it up a wee bit, and also I wanted to give the speakers a warm up before I went blasting them. So what I'm going to do is just play music off my phone. We'll see what, I'll just, you know, shuffle it and play through all the songs and we'll see what we get. I'll play like a verse and a chorus of each song that I like at quite a loud volume and we'll see how it sounds. Oh, by the way, the other thing I didn't mention is for the amplifier, I have got down here a little PLC2 subwoofer output controller so I can attenuate it a wee bit to make it sound a bit better. So yeah, I'm just gonna play some music and we'll see how it sounds. So I'm just gonna do it over Bluetooth. Should be relatively good quality. I'm gonna have my output volume set at almost maximum because I'm not 100% sure about this, but I've got a feeling iPhones will clip a wee bit at their top volume output even over Bluetooth, so I'm gonna have it down a notch, and then I'd rather turn the head unit up because this can go up to, I think, at least 33 out of 40 before any distortion occurs. The head unit itself doesn't distort, it can go all the way up to maximum without distortion. It's the output side which will start distorting after a while. So I'm just gonna start playing some songs on shuffle mode. We'll see what songs come up and yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy this video. I am leaving the car running, by the way, but the reason I'm not doing a driving test, well, doing it while I'm driving, is because I haven't sound deadened my car yet and so a lot of road noise would come in, so I'm just doing it stationary. Let's just find some songs. You feel that? That's 33 out of 40 and that's where I'm gonna stop. just realized I didn't really say before, but the main point of this video is to test the quality of the subwoofer, not so much the speakers at this point. Like, it can go louder, but I want to see how well the subwoofer responds from this little 5-channel amplifier in that box that I built, which is quite small. next song.
Tell me what you want, tell me that you need me. I've been waiting all night for you to tell me what you want, tell me that you need me.
going a wee bit. Big build up. one more. It's a crazy, ridiculous dubstep song. One more song. I'm only really playing songs that are worth playing to test a subwoofer. You know, a bit of heavy bass rock here and there, obviously EDM stuff, but you know, nice relaxing acoustic or classical songs, they don't have that much bass, there's not really much point in playing them anyway. Okay, I think that'll do for the testing, guys. I've given my speakers and my subwoofer and probably my amp an absolute workout. As I said, yeah, I was only playing songs that are really worth playing. If there was a song you wanted to hear and I didn't play, I'm sorry, there's not really much I can do about it. But my opinions, in case it doesn't really come through on the camera, I'm not sure how good the GoPro mic really is, but out of the other cameras and things I've used to demonstrate music before, the GoPro I think actually has worked the best, because phones, the microphone distorts really easily. My digital camera, when it detects high volume, it just mutes it, and the GoPro seems to hold up pretty well, so that's why I used it. How it sounds, for rock music, it's so fucking perfect. That box size, the power of the sub with the PLC2 turned maximum up to maximum volume, which just would be the same as if I didn't have it plugged in, so just how I have it set is perfect for rock. Just the right amount of bass for like the bass guitar and the floor bass drum, you know, perfect for things like hip hop, drum and bass, dubstep, like anything that has an extra bass line on it. I tend to turn it down to maybe like 80%, 75 to 85% range, turning it down to there makes it sound a bit better, otherwise it just sounds a wee bit overkill, if you know what I mean. Like all you hear is bass coming through, because it actually performs really well. The reason I made this video now later and rather than when I first installed it is because it took about a week for the subwoofer to, you know, warm up, run in, loosen up and get ready to move, because the first week it was quite stiff, but it sounds so good now. I'm super happy with how it turned out. And as I have said in other videos, this car, the game for this car is SQ, so sound quality. I wasn't trying to get the most SPL I possibly could. Like in my Legnum, I had my two Rockford Fosgate 15s and I loved it because you can make the mirror flop back and forth, you can make the windscreen flex, you can make the microphones on any camera distort and go, you know, like a Steve Mead video. But that wasn't my game for this car. This car I wanted to do, I did the SPL, and now I'm doing the sound quality, and sound quality is so nice to have. But the good thing is it can still go loud as well. It's just not quite the same experience as 215s. Like you get in a car with 215s and it's an experience in itself. Like you sit in your seat and go, whoa, you know. But this is just like really nice listening. You can listen to any song and it sounds better than it does through headphones. One downside to having an SQ system in your car though, it brings to light all the low quality files you have on your phone. Anything less than 320 kilobits per second, or kilobytes, whatever you want to call it, is instantly exposed as a low quality song on your phone, or whatever your source is. And radio sounds pretty terrible through it, to be honest. It exposes how bad radio broadcasting actually is. So that's one downside. If you're gonna have a really high quality system like this, then you need to have matching high quality audio sources, which is why I have my SD card in here preloaded with FLAC files on them. FLAC files, if you're unsure. If an MP3 on your phone, a high quality one like 320, is the same as a CD, then a FLAC file is the same as a record or vinyl. It's just worlds apart. FLAC files are like WAV files, they're just raw audio. So as opposed to 320 kilobits a second, you're looking more like 1,200 kilobits per second. It's literally four times the quality. JJSC1 commented, congrats on the engagement, guys. Thanks, JJSC1. You commented just now in the middle of filming, so you're getting a shout out. Thanks, man. But yeah, I'm super happy with how the subwoofer system has turned out. Very happy with the speakers at the moment, but as you guys know, I am upgrading these front speakers from the two-way versions to the three-way versions, at which point the tweeters in their current locations will be replaced with the 3-inch mid-ranges, mid-highs, and the tweeters are going on those custom pods that I'm... I think I may need to retune my back speakers a wee bit, because sitting in the back there, all you can kind of really hear is the subwoofer directly behind you and then the tweeters firing straight at you. That's probably because of the way the tweeters are at the moment. If you have your tweeters on top of the dash like I do, facing straight up at the windscreen acts as like a giant reflector and just pushes all the sound directly straight backwards. So that's probably because of that. I'll do some retuning, obviously, as I go. If you have any questions about the system or about what I thought it sounds like, maybe a genre that I didn't play but in this video but I may have played before, any questions about how it sounds, please don't hesitate just to drop a comment and I'll answer them. As I say in all my videos, guys, thanks for watching, choose to be happy, and I'll catch you in my next video. Ka kite anō.
Somewhere beyond the sea, somewhere waiting for me, my lover stands on golden sands and watches the ships.